Hello my dear friends, welcome to Sparkle with Jyoti. For the people who are new to my channel, I welcome you all, and my name is Jyoti and I do videos on travel, mommyhood, inspiration, skincare, makeup, and you know the culture and traditions what goes on in Sweden. So welcome to my channel. So today I'm going to talk about the system of preschool and you know the daycare system what goes on in Sweden. And if you're interested in this, please keep on watching. I realize that as parents we are always so concerned about our kids and you know worried, you know, that we're changing the countries and you know what kind of system will be there, what kind of people will be there to take care of our kids. So to do away all those fears and all those anxiety and all those questions, I'm here to guide you and inform you about the preschool system, because my daughter is also in the same age. She is 2 years few months, and she goes to preschool here. She started from August last year, and it was a little bit difficult in the beginning because the language is different, as they speak Swedish in the Swedish preschools. You can also there are also international schools available, so if you want you can put the kids in that place also, and there they speak English, so it's bilingual. They speak English and Swedish together, but more of English. But the problem is that where the housing is located, where your house is located from that place, the preschool, that international preschool, is quite far, and I don't feel the need or the, you know, the necessity for the kids, you know, so small to travel, and you know, like it's like going 1 hour, coming 1 hour, so it's quite tiring for the kids, as well as you have to invest like, you know, a separate 1 hour, 1 and 1.5 hour in the morning as well as afternoon to drop and pick up the kids. So I don't feel any point in that. So that's the reason I am sending my daughter to a nearby preschool, which is like 5 minutes walking distance for me, and it works out very well for her as well as me. Starting with the admission process, the waiting period is quite long, so it's I advise you, you know, to take admission for your son or daughter quite early. So I had registered for my daughter when she was just 4 months old, but the waiting period is 6 months, you know. So whenever you feel that okay, fine, you know, you are going to put the kid in the daycare or the preschool, it's better to register 6 to 8 months prior. Okay, so that is my second advice. The kids are given admission, you know, usually like, you know, 99% nearby your house, and nearby it's like, you know, a municipality. So, you know, it falls under different categories. So, for example, there is, you know, Göteborg, there is Moldal, there is, you know, different kinds of municipalities. So, they assign you the school nearby to your house, so that will be easier for your kid and for you to, you know, travel and, you know, drop your kid and pick up the kid. Once you have got the admission for your child, you have an in-schooling period of 15 days, that is 2 weeks, in your preschool. So what you're supposed to do is you need to go with the child in the school, preschool, and you're supposed to stay with the kid for the entire duration. So there is an entire timetable which you are given on the first day of your arrival, and it is mentioned there. So basically, because the idea behind that is that the kid, you know, should be used to the environment and the other kids and the, you know, teachers or the caretakers. So what they do is they you know, start from 1 hour, they increase it to 2 hour, 3 hour, 4 hour period gradually. It all depends on you, how much time you want to keep your kid in the preschool. So the age limit is you can start the preschool right from the child is 1 year old, and the preschool period is 1 to 6 years. After 6 years you graduate to another school, but all these years you can be in the preschool. So okay, once your kid is settled and the 15 days, it's not mandatory that it has to be 15 days, and for my example I had almost done 3 months of in-schooling, which is like weird, I know, but my daughter was not at all adjusting to the school environment, and she was not at all happy. She used to cry, like, you know, a lot of hours, and it was really stressing for me as well as her. So they suggested us to take a break for another 2-3 months and then come back, and I also changed her school, so it was really helpful for me. And yeah, I mean, you need to sometimes take cues, you know, from your child, because every child is different, and you cannot expect, you know, that like other kids, you know, your child will also will be very happily adjusted to the environment. So you need to you know, get that facts and, you know, understand your personality personality of your child and, you know, take decisions likewise. So your child is settled and the teachers are confident, you know, that the child is ready to be in the school by himself or herself, they will, you will be stopped from coming and you can, you know, just drop your kid and go off. So usually I would like to mention the timetable what goes along here. So for example, my daughter, I drop her at 9 o'clock in the morning, and after that, basically the school starts from 6 o'clock in the morning, so you can drop the kid as early as 6 o'clock also if you're going for, you know, work purposes outside. So the breakfast is served mostly around 8 to 8:30, that is breakfast served, and I drop my daughter at 9 o'clock, so I make sure that she has breakfast at home and then she goes to school. Okay, so you can choose to drop the kid at 8 o'clock so that they, you know, have breakfast along with other kids, and breakfast and food, I mean, you don't have to worry about at all. It's at most healthy and they have various options, so not one thing is repeated daily, so they have different menu options on different days, and they have really healthy, they have salads on, like, you know, every day, so you don't have to worry about the, you know, quality or the health side of the food. It's extremely healthy and extremely don't drop her safe, at 9 o'clock, my daughter, to the school. Then from 9 to almost 11 o'clock, that is playtime, so they have various amazing toys in the school. So they're like, there is a kitchen, you know, a small kitchen for the, you know, kids kitchen. There are lots of dolls, lots of books, painting, drawing, and, you know, lots of toys. I mean, the entire preschool is designed in such a way, it's you know, completely appealing to the kids and completely kid friendly, okay, and kid safe. So each and every corner is protected in such a way that even if the kid falls or, you know, stumbles upon, he will not get hurt, he or she will not get hurt, and, you know, that's really, really, really good. It's very, you know, soothing for the parent to you know, trust them and leave your kid there, and, you know, you're completely assured that the kid is taken care of and is at a most safe place. Okay, so that is the thing. So 9 to 11 they have their playtime, they have their activities. If the weather is good, they take them out, the teachers take the kids out in the nature and to the forest or nearby place for a walk, you know, a nature walk, and it's really good. And between 11 to 11:15, the lunch is served, and all the kids sit together. So basically, the tables are divided. So if there are three teachers, each teacher has a table which has around 5 to 6 kids, and she is responsible for that particular table and for that many kids. So she makes sure that the kid, you know, is eating properly. They don't they don't believe in pampering the child, so they don't feed the kid by hand. But then if the kid is really small, like, you know, 1 year and, you know, 1.5 year, or just started to, you know, eat by herself or himself, then they will make sure, you know, that they give a helping hand. But they want, the basic idea theirs is to make the kids independent, you know, as much early as possible, so that the kids feel confident to ask or do whatever they want as per their, you know, timings. So that is the thing. So they give the lunch, and at 11:15 to 11:30 or 11:45, the kids finish their lunch and then they go to sleep. So 11:30, 11:45 to 1 o'clock, the kids sleep. Earlier the timings were different, so they used to the kids used to sleep as much as they want, but now the regulations have changed, so they mostly allow the kids to sleep at 45 minutes to 1 hour, and they make sure, you know, the kids wake up, and then again the playtime starts. So once they wake up, they give, if the kid is hungry, they give like an apple, a banana, or some kind of seasonal fresh fruits, and they make sure that the kid is playing. And after that, at 2:30, around 2:33 is the usual time when the parents come and pick up the kids. And I usually go at around 1:30 to 2 o'clock because she is fresh and she is played well and everything, and I pick her up. And so working parents can keep their kids up till 5 o'clock. That's the, you know, official time of the school, and many parents do that because they don't have any other option. There is no help or there's no care available here. Babysitters are available here on occasional basis, but it's quite expensive. I think the rate is 100 to 150 per hour, and I find it a little expensive, so I don't think so that that option is preferable by Indians especially. So I just wanted to inform you all the parents who are coming from India, you know, and other countries to Sweden, the childcare is really best. I mean, they really invest their time and energy so much in the kids. I can see, you know, that you know, there are some cues and habits and, you know, personality of your kids which you are aware about, but I can, you know, really feel that when I go and pick up my daughter, the teacher, you know, she knows also, like, we both are on the same page. So she knows my daughter as much as I do. I know that sounds a little bit strange, you know, but I wanted to tell you the truth. So yeah, I mean, I must say that the school what I have found is really good. So the teachers are really very warm and very loving and very caring, and they make sure that the child is aware, you know, that what is the child feeling and what is she up to and what does she like.
So basically, like, the dry teachers, you know, try their best to you know, design their outlook towards the kids, you know, on individual basis.
So depending on each kid, as you know, each kid is different, so they try to do it, you know, with very much love and warmth. That is what I love about you know, the system here, the child care system. And I mean, you can really feel very relaxed, you know, while I'm leaving my daughter. I'm relaxed. I know that even if, you know, I'm leaving her for 4-5 hours, whatever, she is in safe hands and I don't have to worry about anything. And if anything happens, or if you know, she is hurt or she's not well, or even if she's crying, they will call me, okay? Because they don't believe in the kids, you know, crying out for longer period of time. So I think they have a limit of 20 minutes to half an hour, and the kid is crying longer than that, then they will call you. And even if you're working or in wherever you are, you need to come and pick up your kid, okay? Also, if your child is not well, then there is various, you know, various kind of options here. So if and there are various kind of sickness also here. So if your baby is, like, you know, not well, she has a fever, or she has been vomiting, or she is overall you know, not well and not herself, then you need to wait out for between 24 hours to 72 hours before you send your child to school. So now you have to keep your child at home with you and comfort the child and be with the child, you know, because they believe that some kind of virus and some kind of bacteria are quite strong, and if you send your child to the school, the other kids will also catch it, and you know, other kids will also fall sick. So that's the reason they advise you to be you know, to be at home with your child. So I just wanted to tell you all these things, and I hope it is helpful for you parents out there. And if you have any more questions, you can send me to sparklewithjyoti@gmail.com. you can also directly message me on Instagram, Jyoti Sparkle, and I'll be happy to answer all your questions. So thank you for watching. Thank you. Take care. Hey though. Bye bye.